Hello student, welcome to the lecture series of complex number. Today in this lecture we are going to learn about what is complex number, geometrical representation of complex number and algebra of complex number. Okay, so let us understand first of all what is complex number. Okay, so the complex number are an extension of the real number by introducing an imaginary unit I, where I is equal to under root of minus 1. Okay, so why we need complex number? So for example, we have equation that is find out the solution for x square plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, so at that time we will get answer next step, that is x square is equal to minus 1. Okay, now we cannot find out the square root of any negative number. Okay, it is not possible to find out the square root of any negative number. Okay, so at that time we have to introduce imaginary number I. So we can put under root of minus 1 is equal to I. Okay, so this will become x is equal to plus or minus under root of minus 1. Okay, so now by introducing imaginary unit I, we can put under root of minus 1 is equal to r. So we will get our answer, that is x is equal to plus or minus r. So we will get easily solution for square root of any negative number by introducing under root of minus 1 is equal to I. Okay, so at that time we can use imaginary unit I, and this is the main need of imaginary unit I to find out the square root of any negative number. Okay, now let us understand what is complex number. Okay, so a complex number Z is an ordered pair x, y of real number x and y. It is Z is equal to x plus I y, where x is real part of Z and it is denoted by real part of Z, where I y is imaginary part of Z and it is denoted by imaginary part of Z. Okay, where I is equal to under root of minus 1 is known as imaginary unit. Okay, if we have complex number which is in the form of Z is equal to 0 plus IY, where X is equal to 0 but Y is not equal to 0, so that is Z is equal to IY, which is called purely imaginary part. Okay, if we have x plus 0i complex number where x is not equal to 0 and y is equal to 0, so that is Z is equal to x and it is called as purely real part or purely real number. Okay, let us understand next, if Z is equal to xy, that is complex number. So Z bar is equal to x minus iy, that is called conjugate of complex number. Okay, now the even power of I is either 1 or minus 1 and odd power of I is either I or minus I. Okay, for example, I is equal to under root of minus 1. So I square is equal to I into I, that will become minus 1. Okay, next is I cube, that is I square into I. Okay, and now here we have I square is equal to minus 1, so we can say that I cube is equal to minus I. Okay, next is I raised to 4, that is nothing but I square raised to whole square. So I square is minus 1, so this will become minus 1 raised to whole square, so our answer is 1. Next is I raised to 5, that is nothing but I raised to 4 into I. Okay, and I raised to 4, that is 1 into I, so this will become I. Okay, so we can say that the even power of I is either 1 or minus 1 and odd power of I is either I or minus I. Okay, now next is what is geometrical representation of complex number. Okay, so here we have x-axis, that is called real axis. Second is y-axis, that is called imaginary axis. And we have any complex number. There are four quadrants. This one is first quadrant. This one is second quadrant. this one is third quadrant and this one is fourth quadrant. Okay, so if we have x and y, both are in positive form, then we can say that our complex number is in first quadrant. Okay, so this is the representation of complex number in first quadrant, where x and y both are positive. If x is negative and y is positive, so we can say that our complex number is in second quadrant, okay, where x is negative and y is positive. If x and y both are negative, so we can say that our complex number is in third quadrant, okay, where x and y both are negative. Fourth is, if x is positive and y is negative, so we can say that our complex number is in fourth quadrant, okay. So if we have both x and y, both are in positive form, so here we have to represent complex number in first quadrant. If x is negative, y is positive, then complex number representation will be in second quadrant. If x is negative, y is negative, then we have to represent complex number in third quadrant. And if x is positive and y is negative, then we have to represent complex number in fourth quadrant. Okay, so this is Argand diagram, and that is the geometrical representation of any complex number. Okay, next is algebra of complex number. Okay, so what is algebra of complex number? So first one is addition. If z1, for example, if we have two complex number, first one is z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1 and z2 is equal to x2 plus iy2. So the addition of two complex number, that is z1 plus z2, will become addition of real part and addition of imaginary part. Okay, that is x1 plus x2. Here x1 and x2 both are real part, and iy1 plus iy2 both are imaginary part. So by taking I common, we will get plus iy1 plus y2. For example, we have two complex number. First one is 1 plus I and second one is 1 plus 2i. This one is our complex number 1, z1 is equal to, and this is z2 is equal to. So the addition of z1 plus z2 will become 1 plus I plus 1 plus 2i. Okay, so addition will become addition of real part, that is 1 plus 1, this will become 2, and addition of imaginary part, that is I plus 2i, so this will become 2 plus 3i. Indirectly our answer will be in the form of any complex number. Okay, this is again we will get answer in complex number. Second is subtraction. So if we have z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1 and z2 is equal to x2 plus iy2, then subtraction of any two complex number will become x1 minus x2 plus iy1 minus y2. Okay, for example, we have z1 is equal to 1 plus I and z2 is equal to 1 plus 2i. Okay, so z1 minus z2 will become 1 plus I minus 1 plus 2i. Okay, so this will become 1 plus I minus 1 and minus 2i. Okay, so this minus 1 plus 1 cancel out. So here we will get minus I only, and we can say that this is nothing but 0 minus I, where real part is 0 and imaginary part is 1. So this is called purely imaginary complex number. Okay, next is multiplication. If z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1 and z2 is equal to x2 plus iy2, then multiplication of any complex number will become x1 plus iy1 into x2 plus iy2. Okay, by solving this two bracket, according to multiplication rule, we will get x1 into x2 minus y1 into y2. This is the real part plus I, x2 into y1 plus y2 into x1, this is imaginary part. Okay, for example, we have two complex number, that is 1 plus I, second is 1 plus 2i. So multiplication of two complex number, that is z1 into z2, this will become 1 plus I into 1 plus 2i. Okay, so multiplication rule of two bracket, this will become 1 into 1, that is 1, 1 into plus 2i, this will become plus 2i, this is I into 1, this will become plus I, and plus this will become 2i square. Okay, now we know that this is 1 plus 2i plus I, this will become 3i. And now we know that I square is equal to minus 1. So this will become I square is equal to minus 1. So this is minus 2. So finally we will get minus 1 plus 3i. This is our final answer. Okay. Where I square is equal to minus 1. Okay. Now next is division. If z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1 and z2 is equal to x2 plus iy2, then division of two complex number will become z1 upon z2 is equal to x1 plus iy1 upon x2 plus iy2. Okay, now in next step, take conjugate with opposite sign. So this will become x1 plus iy1, x2 plus iy2 into x2 minus iy2, x2 minus iy2. And by solving this two bracket in numerator and denominator, in denominator this is a plus b, a minus b. So we know that a plus b, a minus b is nothing but a square minus b square. Okay, so in denominator here we have x square, a square minus b square condition. Okay, and in numerator, by solving this two bracket according to multiplication rule of complex number, so we will get this our final answer. This one is our real part and this one is our imaginary part. Okay, for example, let us understand with example. Here we have z1 is equal to 1 plus I and z2 is equal to 1 minus 1 plus 2i, for example. Okay, so division of this both complex number, that is z1 upon z2, this is 1 plus I and this is 1 plus 2i. Okay, now by taking conjugate with opposite sign of complex number which is in denominator, so this will become 1 plus I upon 1 plus 2i into 1 minus 2i into 1 minus 2i. Okay, in numerator we have 1 plus I into 1 minus 2i. Okay, so by solving this bracket in numerator, so we will get this 1, then 1 minus 2i, that is minus 2i, I into 1, that is plus I, and I into minus 2i, this will become minus 2i square. And in denominator we have a plus b, a minus b, so this is 1 plus 2i and this is 1 minus 2i, so this is a plus b, a minus b. So our answer is a square minus b square. Okay, so for this our answer is 1 minus 4i square. Okay, and we know that I square is equal to minus 1. So our answer will become 1 plus 4 and this is 5. Okay, because I square is equal to minus 1. So minus minus plus. So this will become 1 plus 4. This is plus 5. Okay, so this is plus 5. Now in numerator, addition of real part. Here also we have I square. Okay, so put I square is equal to minus 1. So we will get this 1 minus 2i plus I and this will become plus 2 because I square is equal to minus 1 and upon 5. So we will get this addition of real part. This will become 2 plus 1. This is 3. And minus 2i plus I, this will become minus I by 5. So we can write like this, 3 by 5, that is our real part. And minus I by 5, this one is our imaginary part. Okay, so today in this lecture we have studied about what is complex number, what is geometrical representation of complex number, and how we can find addition, subtraction, multiplication and division of any two complex number. Okay, thank you for watching this video.